Today we're going to learn how to fix that error which says unknown database in PHP MyAdmin. So now what we're gonna do, we're going to go to your terminal. You can go to your terminal and start those two services. Let me get a new terminal and start the services. I remember I made a video, same video, but in that video I was not talking, so I'm very sorry about that. A lot of people complained and they did not like the video because it was not even that clear, and also it did not have any sound in that. There was a reason why I did that, but now I'm going to repeat the same video, but this time I'm talking and it's going to be a little bit clear and easier to fix. So, okay, what you're going to do, start the service. We're using Kali Linux, but whichever operating system you use is fine, but in Kali you have to start the service for Apache 2. Then you say start. After start, hit enter, and then you also say service MySQL start. We start that service also. After doing that, we say yes. Okay, we've started those two services. If you're using Windows, you know what to do, but that's the way we do things in Kali Linux. So you go to your browser. Once you start that, you can say local host /php my admin. So yes, you hit enter. Once you hit enter, you have to go to SQL, then you click SQL, then you say use. Okay, you not user, it has to be use space my first db. Okay, we're using this db, and we say we want to use that. After that, we're gonna select. Now you see we have that error which says 10.4.9 unknown database my first db. You get me? So now the reason why we're getting this error is we mistyped the database. You can see the database we're trying to use here is let's go back here, I tell you. Okay, the database we're trying to use here is let me go up, is my first db, and but there is an A inside here, so that simply means your database is giving you that error because of what? Unknown database first, let me see. Okay, let me copy this error anyway, guys. Okay, that's the thing I want. I was trying to tell you that the problem is here. You put A here, so check into your DB before you use it and see if the spelling is right. Okay, I'm fixing that. I fixed that. I took out the A. You can see the database. To do it right, maybe you can double click on that. Say okay. Okay, after that, you go here and select that. Okay, once you select that, you go back to that. It's already anyway selected, but okay, you can say use, and you put that. Okay, why do I always put user instead of use? You put that, say use, then you put exactly, you copy and paste that. Then after that, you copy this, just for instance, if you want to repeat something, then you run. You can see it says returned an empty result, which is fine. So it means the database is fine. So but now what we're gonna do, we want to run our query and see if it works. We use that, and into the database there's a table called classes, and say select star from classes. Then after saying select star from classes, then you're gonna say you're gonna hit enter, then you say hit wow. I'm getting another error which I never expected. So let's see why. It says you have an error in your SQL. Check the manual corresponding to your MariaDB server version for the right syntax. Select stuff from classes. What's wrong with that? Select stuff from classes. Select stuff from classes. Classes is the table I want to do, and this is the database I'm trying to use. I wonder why is that. Okay, I'm gonna repeat my table. I'm gonna just select. I'll take that. And say star. Then from. Okay, then classes, I'm gonna say classes. If it comes, then I'm gonna select that and I see if it's gonna work. I really don't know. Oh, the reason could be we selected a database already here. From I think because we selected a DB already. So let me sign out and I go here. I want to use it the way I have to use it. I go here and say localhost php my admin is gonna be php okay, I'm selecting this php my admin. Yes, you see there's no database selected. I'm gonna just go here and paste this. Okay, my query is not wrong. Maybe because I used to select a database which is selected already, same thing. Okay, anyway, let me click here and go back here. I'm not going to use that select stuff. Okay, let me see classes. And let me see. Yeah, you can see it worked, but it's okay. So what we want to show you, what we wanted to show you before previously, it was this, that we mistyped the database. If you say use that database, use the database we want to use, which is gonna be my first. Let's just select enter. Yeah, you can see it works, guys. So this is the way to fix that error. I don't think it's gonna be a major issue, but in the process you might be doing many things and you see you get the problem. But anyway, you the only reason you're getting that error is that you mistype in the database you want to use. To prove it again, I'm gonna go back. I want sometimes when I do something, somebody to be sure that what we're doing is the right thing. MySQL, it's going to be localhost, php my admin. You enter, click enter there. Okay, then you go to your SQL and you say use, but this time we're going to just misspell it and put a zero here deliberately. And after doing that, we're gonna say go, and you can see it gives you the same mistake, so same error. So that simply means, guys, whatever you do, try to check the database only. You see that database name, the database name, it's the problem why it's giving you that error. There could be two things: either that database is not created, or you have to create that database, the one you put in your in this line, or you misspelling the DB. So the DB is not the one of the reasons, or you got a wrong spelling. So if you have a wrong spelling, so it means you, or you created it and maybe something happened, or the way you created it is not the same name. Like me, I'm saying my first TB, maybe this one I named it in a wrong way and I'm writing the right spelling I wanted to write, and here it's wrong. So what you do, you can double click and copy there, or you have to check, or you create the new database in that. Okay guys, please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.